In my journey as an economics teacher, one of the most common questions asked by students or their parents when selecting economics as an elective subject is, how much math is involved in economics? For some students, mathematics can be overwhelming. Graphs are used as a tool by economists to build their theories and models of the real world. We use them in microeconomics, macroeconomics, and international trade. You need to understand the graphs to lay a strong foundation for the subject. This video is quite basic, and some of you might already know this. But in my experience, I do find students feeling stressed, and many get confused when they come across hundreds of graphs. Here, my attempt is to guide you step by step. This should help you to create and interpret the graphs on your own. And hopefully, there would not be much need to memorize them. Let's start. In order to understand how to construct a simple graph that shows the relationship between two variables, first we should learn few important terms used in graphs. The point where two lines on a graph cross is called an intersection point. An intercept is where a line on a graph crosses the x-axis or the y-axis. The x-intercept is the value of x when y is 0, and the y-intercept is the value of y when x is 0. Another important term to know is slope. The slope tells us how steep a line on a graph is as we move from one point on the line to another point. Technically, slope is the change in the vertical axis divided by change in the horizontal. The formula for calculation of slope is rise over run. Now we need to understand what is a function. Function is an expression or rule that defines a relationship between two variables where the value of one would be dependent on another. Now, if I say y is a function of x, in this case, y is a dependent variable and x is an independent variable. The value of y depends on the value of x. Let us assume one equation for a line. Y is equal to mx plus b. In this equation, m is the slope and b is the y intercept. To make it easier, let us add numbers to the equation. So the same thing I'm going to write as, by adding numbers to this equation, y is equal to 2x plus 3. Here b term would be 3 and b would be 3, and m term from the above equation would be 2. The b term is the y-intercept. The reason is that if x would be 0, if I am going to put x value to be 0, So if I am going to put x value to be 0 in my above equation, which is 2 into 0 plus 3, the value of y would be 3. This is known as y-intercept. The reason is b will reveal where the line will cross the y-axis. In this example, the line will hit the y-axis at 3. When I will draw this curve using a table, you will understand this better. The m term in the equation for the line is the slope of the curve.
Slope is defined as rise over run, as we discussed in our last slide. In this example, each time in this example, the equation which we have taken, y is equal to 2x plus 3, this means that each time the value of x term increases by 1, the y term will rise by 2. Thus, the slope of this line would be 2 upon 1, which is equal to 2. Now, we are going to take one example. I am going to assign the values to x to derive the values of y. How we do that? In this equation, if x is equal to 0, what would be the value of y? Y would be 2 into 0 plus 3, which is equal to 3. If I assign x as 1, y would be equal to 2 into 1 plus 3, which is 5. X is equal to 2, y is equal to 2 into 2 plus 3, which is equal to 7. This way, I can derive different values of x and y. Based on this, I can draw a table. X, y. Now, if the value of y was 0, x value was 3, 1, 5, 2, 7, 3, 9, 4, 11, 5, 13, 6, 15. Now, how are we going to plot this graph? I have already taken, I have drawn these two axes, OX and OY. I am going to take the values of X on OX axis and the values of Y on this axis. So, how am I going to go about it? First, I need to look at the values of X. If I look at the values of X, they are all equally divided and the greatest number is 6, which will definitely fit on OX axis easily. So, let me divide this into equal parts, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, I am going to assign numbers here. When I have to look at OY axis, I want to plot the values of Y. Always keep two things in mind. First, you look at the greatest number. The greatest number is 15. Make sure that it gets fit on OY axis. And the second thing we have to keep in mind that it is divided into equal proportions. Now, there are two ways to do here. I can either take a table of 2 until 16 I can plot these values, or even I can take a table of 3 and plot it till 15. You can choose any one. I am going to choose the table of 3. So, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. Now, let's start plotting these points. I am going to take a different color so it's more visible to you. So, if I take value of x to be equal to 0, the value of y should be 3. So, it means my first point should be here. My second point would be value of 1, x1 and y to be 5. Value of 2, when x is 2, it has to be somewhere 7. Then we are going to just join these points with continuous hand. This is a curve, this is a line we got for y is equal to 2x plus 3. Now, what kind of a relationship is this line showing? Let's say at this point of y and this point of x, and if I increase the value of x to this point, the value of x is also increasing. Or the other way, if the value of x is going to this point, the value of y is also going higher. It means there is a direct relationship between the two variables. There is a direct relationship. So when the curve is going upwards on a graph, it means it shows a direct relationship between the two variables. When the value of one variable is increasing, the other also is increasing. This understanding of graphs is very, very important for us to know. Once you get enough idea of how to look at the direction of these curves and what are the two variables we are taking, we can build our theories based on this. And this is how economists try to use math or try to use graphs as tools to explain or to build their theories.
This is one example to show you what kind of mistakes we tend to make. If you look at this graph, bar graph, you will find that the frequency axis, OY axis, is not starting at 0. It's starting at 2. Always remember that it should start at 0. Another mistake is that this was not labeled. Frequency axis was not labeled. And even this side, the student might have missed blue. So category axis also, the color was also not labeled. Another major mistake you come across is non-uniform spacing. So children tend to, like if you look at this figure, you have two squares, then two squares, but here you have only one square. So we need to be very, very clear when we are drawing graphs not to make these type of mistakes. When you are dividing your data, your numbers into equal proportions, we also need to look at the concentration of values. For example, the left-hand side is showing the same data where the change is not that much visible over time. But the same values plotted on the right-hand side is showing that change, which is quite visible. So how we divide the scale on a graph is also very important. When you are doing trend analysis, when you are interpreting data of that sort, you need to keep these things in mind. Otherwise, you can present a distorted picture.
We will discuss with examples how this knowledge of graphs is applied by the economists in my next video. If you find this video valuable, kindly like and subscribe. You are most welcome to visit my website www.economadeeasy.com, where you can read blogs on different topics related to economics. Bye.